What if I told you that even the worst neighborhood in America could be made completely safe? How do I know this? Because it's happening right now in every country in the world but this one. It is great to see American machines helping to promote peace abroad. So then tell me, why can't we use these machines here at home?
Hi there, really nice to meet you. I really enjoyed the film, saw it last night. There's been a lot of talk about the rating of the film, and what was the toughest thing about getting the film to have a PG-13? And did a lot of stuff get cut, and will there be a director's cut of the film?
Right, well, you watched the director's cut. We got lucky this way. I didn't really think about rating when I was doing the movie. To me, a movie has to have the amount of violence or sex or whatever that is compatible with its internal logic. So if you're making a movie like, say, Clockwork Orange, you need violence, because without violence, you cannot express the ideas that are in that film. Now, if you're doing, you know, Gone with the Wind, that's another matter. I mean, each movie has its own internal structure, and I think I did what I needed for my film. I mean, our film talks about the risk of fascism in the face of the automation of violence, on one hand. And on the other hand, it talks about what is it that defines us as human beings and not as machines. Is it our consciousness? Is it our emotions? What is that? In order to discuss those issues, I don't need brains being splattered in windows. I need violence in another way. Like, there's a scene in the movie where Alex Murphy is placed in front of a mirror and he has to confront what's left of him. And there is a lot of existential violence in there. I mean, I even challenged the notion of violence. People usually equate violence with bullets. I've shot movies that have bullets in it, Elite Squad, very violent movies. And I feel that the most violent film I've done in my life hasn't got one bullet in it. And it's about hunger. I mean, so this whole rating thing to me is distorted anyways. I don't care about it.
Fair enough. Very good answer. Is there anything you miss, you know, about making, say, smaller, more independent movies? Do you miss that freedom, or is it a different way of working on a larger scale film?
Well, when I all my movies prior to RoboCop were I financed, I wrote, produced, direct, and some of them I distributed myself. So I'm clearly a very spoiled filmmaker. Now, in Hollywood, in a big studio movie, you can have freedom, but you have to fight for it. So you value it even more because you're fighting for your ideas. Now, the Hollywood system is set up in a way where there's been an historical negotiation between the creative side of things and the studio executive side of things. And there are rules set up by the DGA, Directors Guild of America, which allow you to do your cut and preview it to an audience. Which we did, and we actually getting there. We got back up from the studio because I got my Brazilian director of photography, a Brazilian editor, a Brazilian composer, a Brazilian director. It's really a Brazilian movie, and you know, we previewed that Brazilian movie in front of an audience, and they liked it. And not only did they like it, when the studio asked questions about why did they like it, they said we like it because it's political. Mm. And once we got that, you know. We got away with it. It's basically what happened.
Cool. Speaking of Brazilian, was it your decision to alter the colour of RoboCop's suit to black? Were you ever tempted to go for, like, you know, Brazilian yellow, bit of blue in there, that sort of thing?
No, we tried to ground the movie because one of the reasons to make this movie for me is because what was fictional back in the day, back in 87, it's current now. I mean, we are automating violence. We are using drones. We'll soon be replacing soldiers by robots and policemen too. So it's going to happen. And because it's going to happen, I wanted to make the film feel realistic up to a point, grounded in reality. And the truth is that all special police forces, SWAT, the Elite Squad, SAS, you name it, they all wear black. And there's a reason why they wear black, because it's harder for the criminal to see you. So we try to ground this way. Also, we try to make a joke, right? They can change the color of RoboCop's body whatever way they like, on a whim, despite of what he thinks about it. Mm. So he's kind of like a product that way. But we always went back to the original suit because that's, you know, we know what it is.
Yeah. Cool. Thanks very much. Really nice to meet you.
Thank you for your cooperation.